students, how are you? I hope you all are fine, right? So, I hope you all are clear with the unit 1, okay? If you have any doubt, you can ask us in a group, okay? So, we completed the chapter 1. Now, moving further to the our chapter 2. Open your book, everyone. Open your book. What is around us? What is around us? That is our second chapter. What is around us? This is our second chapter. Okay. So, now, those who don't have book, okay, I'll give you the screenshot of this unit 1, okay. If you don't have a book, then no worry, I'll give you the screenshot of the question answer, okay. Now, what is around us? Pay attention, open your book, page number 6. See, Dhwanmin was roaming in the garden. It means was walking in the garden with his mother while walking, a question arose in his mind. Dhwanmin asked his mother, what is land made up of? What is land made up of? Mother replied, do you see the sun every day? Mother, what mother replied? Mother replied, do you see the sun every day? The sun too has a family. The sun too has a family. Is known as a solar family. What is the sun's family name? Solar family. Our earth is one of the member of the solar family. Our earth is one of the member of the solar family. The most important point is that only the earth among all the members of the solar family has got the suitable temperature, water and air to sustain living being. Water and air to sustain living beings. Generally, it is believed that part of sun which has been detached from the sun after the collision is earth. Generally, it is believed that part of sun which has been detached from the sun after the collision, that is earth. At the time of its origin, it was in the form of a fireball. When the time of its origin, it was in the form of a fireball. This fireball started to cool down slowly. Many animal elements of the earth got transformed into liquid and further into solid form. Now what? See, the earth. In the origin, the earth is like a fireball at the time of origin. Then what happened? Many elements, earth got transformed into liquid. Elements got transformed into liquid. And also element transformed into the solid form also. Right? You learned that liquid and solid form in the science subject, right? (Clears throat) Now, during this process, the element which got transferred into solid are known as the lithosphere. Now, what is the lithosphere? The element are transferred liquid into the solid form is called as a lithosphere. The elements which got transferred into liquid are called the hydrosphere. Those elements are got transferred into the solid form. It is called the lithosphere, and the element are transferred into the liquid form are called the hydrosphere. The element which transfer into gas came to be known as the atmosphere, right? The element which transfer into the gases came to be known as the atmosphere. Above all the living world which developed due to land, water and air came to be known as the biosphere. Above all the living world which developed due to land, water and air came to be known as the biosphere. In this way, the four spheres came into existence on Earth. Now, you can see the picture. You can see the picture. Spheres of the Earth is given. See? This one, right? In that, atmosphere is given, biosphere are given, hydrosphere and lithosphere. All thing is given in this picture. You can see. Now, moving further to the lithosphere. If you want to write, then you can write this keyword. This is Earth. In the origin time, Earth is look like a fireball. Then the element transfer into liquid and solid. Okay, this is only introduction. Now we started the lithosphere. Moving further to the lithosphere. Next topic our is lithosphere. We are discussing the lithosphere. The sphere on which we live is known as the lithosphere. The sphere, the earth is sphere, not the earth is round, okay? The sphere on which we live is known as lithosphere. The sphere where we live, it is called the lithosphere. Litho means rock and sphere means layer. Now here, litho it means rock, and the sphere means layer, right? Litho means rock and sphere means the layer, lithosphere. See, litho, it means rock, and sphere means layer. Now, the upper layer of the earth is made up of soil and solid materials like rock. The upper layer of the earth is made up of soil and solid materials like rock. Approximately 29% of the surface of the earth is covered with the lithosphere. How many percentage? 29% of the earth. 29% of the surface of the earth. Of the surface of the earth are made up, 29% of the surface of the earth is called the lithosphere. This layer is almost 64 kilometer to 100 kilometer thick. How many kilometers are thick? Here I write it down. 64 kilometer to 100 kilometers are thick. The thickness of the lithosphere, is not the same everywhere on the earth. The thick layer is not same everywhere of the earth. Similarly, their interior and exterior do not have identical physical features. Okay, their interior, inner part, inner portion, and the exterior, that is the upper part, do not have identical physical feature. It is mostly made up of substance like soil and rocks. Landforms like mountains, plateaus, plains, and valleys are seen on the lithosphere. How many lands? See. Here I write it down. Here the litho meaning, and here I write it down the further land. Land reforms. Mountains. Then plateaus. Plains and valley. Are seen on the lithosphere. Landforms like mountains, plateaus, plains, and valley. The temperature increases as we move towards the center of the earth. The molten rocks in the interior of the earth are known as magma. Which molten rocks? Here I write it down. Molten rocks in the interior are known as the magma. There are many gases present in the interior of the earth which rise up with pressure and heat. In the inner part, many gases are there. Each rise up with many presses and heat, but the pressure of the rock of the surface of the earth is equally strong. The upper layer is made up of rock, so the pressure of the interior and the exterior are the same, are equally strong. Thus, the balance between the two is maintained. So, balance is maintained. So, the crust of the earth does not break. The layer, upper layer of the earth does not break. When the balance between the two is not maintained, the crust breaks and a volcano erupts. Now, what? The balance between these two, the upper layer and the inner layer, is not maintained. Then crust breaks, the layer breaks and the volcano erupts. Mommy, how is the lithosphere useful to us? Who asked? Dhvanvin asked to his mother. How is the lithosphere useful to us? Where can we construct our home if the lithosphere is not there? Without lithosphere, how can we get the water to drink, agriculture for food, minerals for industry and forest? Draw a picture depicting all the details you observe on lithosphere based on our conversation. This is the activity, right? Now I hope this lithosphere is clear to you. Once again I am repeating this, and then you have to write it down, this in your book, keywords, right? See, first we discuss the lithosphere. Litho, it means rock, and sphere means the layer, lithosphere. In that, 29% of the surface of the earth is made up of lithosphere. 29%, it may ask in the MCQ also. So, you have to learn or you have to underline this, okay? So, you can easily remember. Now, the 64 kilometer to 100 kilometers, there is a thick layer of the surface. So, the landform, how many landform? That is mountain, plateaus, plains and valleys, okay? In the upper part, there is the molten rocks. Molten rocks are also known as the magma, right? And then what we learned? We learned that the upper layer, the interior and the exterior is maintained a balance. Because if they are not maintaining the balance, then what happened? The crust. The layer of the earth was the break, right? Crust is break, and the volcano erupts, okay? The strong rocks and the interior are maintained a strong balance, okay? Now, write it down in your book, right? First, you have to write the meaning litho and sphere, okay? Then, as I write, that way you have to write, okay? In your fair book, you have to write. If you do not have completed your chapter one question answer, then you have to put a plus and then you have to start a chapter 2. Or otherwise you can write in your rough book, then you, if you completed your chapter 1, you will complete your chapter 1, then you can write in, this is in fair book, okay? Okay, done everyone. Now in our next lecture we will learn the hydrosphere. You all have to read it once, okay? If you understand or not, first you have to write the introduction of the earth and then you have to write lithosphere. Or if you have any doubt regarding these two, then you can ask us in a group, okay? Now, or you can ask us in a comment box also. Or you have to read the hydrosphere at once, okay? So, in the next lecture, we will discuss the hydrosphere, okay? And the atmosphere. Okay, now if you have any doubt regarding the chapter 1, you can ask me, okay? Okay, so now we will move further in our next lecture. Till then, take care and bye students.